Nowadays, you can't speak about the state of the blockchain industry without at least mentioning ICOs or initial coin offering. They are a way for new projects, startups, and companies to sell their underlying crypto tokens in exchange for investors' money. Think of ICOs as initial public offering, but instead of investors purchasing a share of a company, they purchase a coin underlying a new project. ICOs are a very different form of equity. Having a new project coin doesn't give you ownership of the project, but instead enables you to use the project when it becomes available. Therefore, by buying into an ICO, it shows that you're interested in this new project, and this incentivizes others to do the same, showing that the project will probably be widely used, since without the associated token, you can't use the project. For example, here are a couple of famous ICOs. Banker ICO raised $150 million, Tezos raised $200 million, and Filecoin raised $253 million. ICOs are permissionless and enable anyone to invest in a project that they feel will be successful. We put emphasis on the word anyone because of the open and public nature of cryptocurrencies. And when you think of it, it's actually pretty wild. From this tweet, 95% of Americans are not allowed by law to invest in startups. Only accredited investors are entitled to do so. But you can buy lottery tickets all you want or go to Las Vegas to gamble. This shows that ICOs are leveling the playing field for investments. Normal people now can invest in any blockchain project they want to. And with many new projects coming out, some with more potential than others, the community needs some way to support them. And that's where ICOs come in. As a comparison, in Q3 2017, ICOs have raised $1.3 billion with 150 ICOs, while seed or angel investing across all tech sectors have raised $1.4 billion across 1,602 deals.